Bonjour. It's time once again to go racing here in Montreal, the second largest French-speaking city in the world, and home since 1978 to the Canadian Grand Prix. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average lap speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Bottas, Leclerc, Lando Norris and Perez, Sainz, Ricciardo, Gasly and Sebastian Vettel, Tsunoda, Stroll, Fernando Alonso and Ocon, Raikkonen, Lundgaard, Mick Schumacher and Antonio Giovinazzi, Russell, Mazepin, Latifi and Jackson. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Good on the power unit cycle, so let's concentrate on bringing tyres and brakes up to temperature. We're in P14. Alonso ahead. Less than a second separate you. They're on fresh softs. Ocon behind. The gap is less than a second. They're on fresh softs. Your pit window will open in 7 laps time. 34 laps to go. DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. Stroll ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 2.5 seconds. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 2 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1 minute 13.1. You're down 8 tenths a lap. Front is 3.0 seconds. Stroll is ahead of you. The gap to the car ahead is 3.3 seconds. They're on old softs. Their tyres are 4 laps old. We think they've got 2 stops remaining. The time last lap was a 1:12.6. Gap to teammate behind is 6.8 seconds. entering the pit window, he'll be on the mediums. Gap to car in front is 3.5 seconds. You are currently in P13. Stroll ahead. Okay. Gap ahead is 3.4 seconds. They're on old softs. Ocon is behind you. Less than a second separate you. The gap to the leader is 15.5 seconds. For now, keep taking care of them. In this lap, push now. Gap to the car in front is 3.1 seconds. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. We'll be doing one more stop today. One stop left in our strategy. nice move. Christian in the pits. Place. The gap to the car ahead is 4.6 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Stroll behind, they're on fresh mediums. Our gap to first place is 22.7 seconds. Gap to car in front is 4.8 seconds. Tsunoda is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 5.2 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 3 laps old. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1 minute 12.0. You're losing around 3/10 a lap. top 10 now. Keep it up, check your MFD for a new strategy option. Copy. Front is 7.7 seconds. P10, you're in P10. The gap to the car ahead is 8.9 seconds. They're on old mediums. Vettel is behind you. The gap is less than a second. They're on old mediums. Okay, gap to leader, 28.8 seconds. Pit window will open in 3 laps time. Pit window opens in 3 laps. 18 laps to go. The pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Front is 10.8 seconds. We've lost a position. That's us down a place. Okay, P10, good. That's put us up into a point scoring position. We're boxing this lap. Give us the best in lap you can. We're leading our teammate by 16.1 seconds. 0.0 seconds. Go, go, go. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. Pushing. We need to reduce the 5 second gap to the car ahead. P15. You're in P15. Mix just ahead. Push for the position. Okay, gap ahead is 5.3 seconds. They're on old mediums. Stroll is behind you. Less than a second separate you. They're on fresh mediums. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. 13 laps to go. Christian is coming in for his stop. The safety car is out. We need you to reduce your pace. It looks like there's a high amount of debris on the track. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy that. Go, go. You'll be racing on the exit. Complete. Go now. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember, there is no overtaking until the green flags. Safety car, in this lap. Okay, the incident has been cleared. Let's get back up to racing speed. Fantastic. Two cars at once. Very well done. You're now in P17. Is strong, but be aware your tires need to go the distance. You have P15. P15, Ocon is ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 1.7 seconds. They're on old mediums. Schumacher behind. They're on fresh hards. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. The track is clear. Green flag. Green flag. The gap to the car ahead is 1.7 seconds. Caution, caution. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. There's four laps of fuel remaining. Is ahead of you. Gap to car in front is 1.1 seconds. They're on old mediums. Their tyres are 10 laps old. The time last lap was a 1:12.9. We're gaining by about 9 tenths a lap. Keep it up. P13, Raikkonen ahead. The gap is less than a second. They're on old mediums. Giovinazzi behind. The gap to the car behind is 1.2 seconds. They're on old mediums. The distance to the leader is 14.9 seconds. That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops. Two laps left. Next time by will be your final lap. This is your final lap of the race. The end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
That's it then for another magnificent Canadian Grand Prix, and they've hung on to take a sublime victory here today. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. And now let's take a look at the driver standings. After an incredible performance, Lewis Hamilton secures the top spot in the Drivers' Championship. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
I have to give it to Jackson. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximised their potential.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, Ferrari have improved their position. A strong weekend from them as they fight their way towards the top. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action. I can't wait to see what's next.